Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. Today, we taste the Dalwhinnie 15 years old Scotch single malt whisky, 43 ABV. And the Dalwhinnie belongs to the famous series, the classic malts of Scotland, which consists out of six individual single malts. And the Dalwhinnie is the third most sold single malt in this series, the most mostly sold single malt whisky is the Lagavulin, then the Talisker, then the Dalwhinnie. After this, we have the Craigan Moore, the Oban, and the last is the Glenkinchie from the Lowlands. They are marketed together since 1989, and so the awareness at the connoisseurs is quite high. So most of you who are interested in single malt whiskies will have had a sip of the Dalwhinnie, 15 years old, and most of the connoisseurs might have bought already a bottle of the Dalwhinnie. The very interesting part in the distillery is its location at a very high pass. If you go the A9 from the motorway from Perth up to Inverness, half the way up in the Highlands, there's an old pass where two trade routes cross, and at that location the distillery is situated. It is not the highest distillery in Scotland, or situated in the highest point, but the second or third highest. The climate in Scotland is quite constant at the borderline, so we have 5 degrees at the lowest and 17, 18 degrees at centigrade at the highest temperatures at the coastline in Scotland, where most of the distilleries or a lot of distilleries are situated. And the more you go into the Highlands, the higher up the distilleries are located, the more the temperatures fall. And at Dalwhinnie, you might reach minus 30 degrees centigrade in the winter. And what happens during these cold times, the alcohol, the whiskey in the cask contracts a lot and tears the air in through the porous structure of the oak wood, of the staves of the cask. And in summer, when the whiskey heats up again, the air is driven out again by the expanding whiskey. And so the cask, breathes in and out. And this results in a more intense maturation of the whiskey in the cask. If your distillery is located at the seashore, then temperatures go from 5 to 15, and that's it, no? So here we have a much broader band of temperatures, and so you also lose a lot of more of the content of the cask, so the angel's share is higher. But you are rewarded by more intense cask aromas. The Dalwhinnie is quite old, 15 years nowadays, where more and more single malt whiskey is sold in the world, the old whiskey is becoming rare. And so a 15-year-old single malt whiskey, popular and not that expensive, below 30 euros. $35 perhaps, or $40. It's not too expensive for a 15-year-old. And so people like it very much because you get the maturation for an affordable price. So there's also a small bottle on the market, a fifth of a liter. And I like these miniature corks. And hopefully these small bottles are sold also in your country. There is a set from there are two sets of three bottles each, different bottles each, which cover the complete Classic Malt of Scotland series. very, very fruity. A hint of heather. Whoa, and fruitiness. Pears. Green apple. Red apple. Some strawberries, raspberries probably. Sweet. There's no oakiness in the nose. There's no peat. It's a fresh, light, fruity, with a hint of a spice in the background. Quite intense for a 43 ABV whiskey, and the oak is there. There's a spiciness from the oak, combining with the fruitiness, sweetness all over your mouth, and the dryness starts from the tip of your tongue. Vanilla is appearing, honey. Excellent long aftertaste. Because of the long maturation period. This one has everything. It has a very fruity and dominant nose, then a astonishingly intense attack on your tongue, very well balanced aftertaste. It's really a masterpiece. And the people like it and buy this bottle very often. A little spiciness, a little oakiness, but sweetness. And if you want to have a good value for your money, you would have a reasonable age for your money, this is the bottle to buy. Thank you for watching whisky.com, and please stay tuned, and if you like this video, give me your thumbs up.